Hey, it's John of FrontRowFactor.com. Question for you today. If you were to rate yourself on your ability to celebrate on a 1 to 10 scale, 10 being the highest, and I'm not just talking about big celebrations, birthdays and holidays, fireworks and cakes, I'm talking about celebrating little moments of life. How would you rate yourself on your ability to celebrate? For me, years ago, the answer would have been a 2 or a 3. And luckily, I had some great mentors that have taught me some strategies over the year to get better at celebrating. And I don't believe it's a skill we're born with. I think it's something that we learn how to do. So I'll give you 2 examples. One, my buddy John Berghoff approached me years ago and said, John, how you doing? And I was going through a really tough time in life. And so I kind of unloaded on him all these difficult situations I was dealing with at one time. And he looked at me and he said, John, I'm jealous. I said, jealous of what? He goes, I'm jealous of the person that you get to become by going through this adversity. I thought about what an interesting take on celebrating the gift in the challenge. A second one of my buddies approached me years later. I was at a fundraising event, and we had 300 people there raising money for Front Row Foundation. He walked up to me and he said, John, hey, pause for a minute. Take a look around and soak this in. He goes, all these people showed up to support Front Row. This is awesome. And I was so busy running to what's next here and what's next there. You ever get into that place where it's always what's next versus what's now? And I was so busy thinking about what needed to be done that I wasn't celebrating what was happening in that moment. So important that we bring attention to the present moment. So where did this idea of celebration come from? And why is it so important to the Front Row community? Well, when we look back over the last 10 years of celebrating more than 100 incredible lives, creating these Front Row experiences, we thought about what's really at work here in the Front Row Foundation. Why is this so effective, and why do people, you know, feel so passionate about this charity and this community? And we realized that it was 3 things that were showing up. One is the power of having hope for the future, something that we're looking forward to down the road. Second was the power of living in the moment. And the third would be that to celebrate our experiences of life, both in the moment and the ones that have already occurred as we look back on those experiences. And when we ask ourselves, what was one key word that was showing up over and over and over again? It was that we were learning how to celebrate life in the Front Row. And to us, that meant being present, being in the moment, focusing on what's now. Celebration meant illuminating or bringing attention to things that we wanted to amplify so we could amplify the good and that we could start to quiet down the things that we didn't want to bring attention to. We could focus on strengths. We could focus on what was right. We could focus on what was right now. And so this is where it all came from. Then we started playing with the word. And, you know, we were looking for a way that at the end of each day, we could celebrate life. And, you know, I'm big into habits and rituals or traditions. And I thought, man, you know, every night at dinner, we've been writing in these journals and capturing our Front Row moments. What if there was a trigger, something that happened every evening that would remind me to celebrate the day? And I thought, what if at 8 p.m. every day, we would celebrate something about the day? We'd kind of go around the dinner table or ask the family. If that was my trigger. And I know it sounds cheesy, but then it hit me. The word celebrate and the number 8 meshing together, I thought, as cheesy as that is, let me roll with that. Let me use that in my life to remind me to celebrate at 8 p.m. each night. And then I thought, man, what else is great about the number 8? Well, there's 8 letters in Front Row. And I thought, that's too good of a coincidence. And then I thought, you know, in the charity, we always talk about, when somebody becomes part of our family, we always talk about it's a forever thing. It's not like we create a Front Row experience and we're done. We want them to be part of our family forever. So you've probably seen that. It's a forever thing. And I thought, oh, if you take that 8 and you flip it on its side, it's the sign for infinity. I thought, oh, that's too perfect. We got to roll with this. So again, as cheesy as it might have been, I thought, this is perfect. Every time I saw 8 p.m., I would celebrate. And then I thought, man, what if we expanded that even more? What if it was just at any time we saw the number 8 or heard the number 8, that we would use that as an opportunity to pause for a second. I mean, it could be that fast, you know, it could be literally a couple seconds and celebrate what's going on. Be appreciative or grateful of what surrounds us. And then one of our team members said, what if the F and the R in front row reminded us to talk about what you're feeling right now? That anytime you saw the number 8, that you just paused to say, what am I feeling right now? How can I be present to this moment? And then somebody else said, John, what if it was that you're feeling right now? That you're feeling right, that what you're feeling is what's right about now. And you amplify that and you celebrate that. That is the essence of what we mean when we say celebrate life in the front row. So my challenge to you today is this. Should you get past the cheesiness of the word celebrate, apply this to your life. And for the next, let's say, 8 days, why don't you try it out? Just maybe write down the number 8 and hang it up anywhere you can, or write down the word celebrate, and then just condition yourself that anytime you see that number, you use it as an opportunity to celebrate something. Let me give you a practical example. Let's say you're at dinner tonight with friends and you're out at a restaurant and you look at the menu and you see something has a price tag, it's got the number 8 in it, and you just pause and say, hey everybody, I just want to take a second and just celebrate this moment that we all have together tonight to come together, you know, and to enjoy this friendship. And then you raise a glass and you toast to the moment. It could be as simple as that. But using a way, a trigger, you know, a sign to remind us to focus on this habit of celebration in our life. So that's my invitation for you today. I would love to hear what you think about this. I'd love to hear what ways that you creatively come up with celebrating your life. And so comment on this video or send us an email or comment on the blog, wherever, just let us know. And if you're not, by the way, part of the Front Row community online, this is an incredible group of people that, you know, basically gets together and believes in the same idea of celebrating life in the front row, being a moment maker, you know, every single day of our lives. And it's not always great, but we can always find what's great about it. And so if you want to join that community, go to frontrowfriends.com. But until next time, keep celebrating, and that is how you will live life in the front row. Take care.